हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू youtube.com/DrVet चैनल। आई एम डॉक्टर पी आर पटेल, प्रोफेसर हेड वेटरनरी मेडिसिन। वी विल डिस्कस हियर बैक्टीरियल डिजीज डर्मेटोफिलोसिस। इन पार्ट वन वी विल डिस्कस सिनोनिम, इंट्रोडक्शन, इटियोलॉजी and epidemiology of dermatophilosis. We will discuss here various synonyms of dermatophilosis. One name is mycotic dermatitis. Word mycotic means fungi, dermatitis inflammation of skin. Here the organism is filamentous type and there is multidimensional septation in the filament. So just look like a fungi. So mycotic dermatitis, it is ascribed in SIP. Another synonym, cutaneous streptothricosis. Here there is plenty of exudation. So exudative dermatitis with heavy scab formation on the skin. So it is named as cutaneous streptothricosis. The third name, lumpy wool of SIP. Here the exudation is met with wool fiber. The wool fiber together at the base and form a crust and large mass, just like a lump of wool. So it is a lumpy wool disease. The fourth synonym is cutaneous actinomycosis. Cutaneous means skin. Actinomycosis means this dermatophilos belongs to actinomycetes group. And the structure of this organism is filamentous type. So cutaneous actinomycosis. Another important name is strawberry foot rot. Here there is proliferative dermatitis, excessive proliferation of the epidermis, and they form a scab. On removal of the scab, there is many bleeding points under the scab on this fleshy mass of the leg skin, and there is ulcerative dermatitis. So it looks like a strawberry foot. So it is called as strawberry foot rot. It is on foot, so foot rot, but name of the fruit is a strawberry fruit. Here we see introduction of dermatophilosis. Here there is superficial skin infection of animals and men. Superficial means mostly epidermis. There is invasion of hair follicles, sweat glands and other epidermal structures. Mostly epidermis is involved. And this disease, dermatophilosis, manifested by exudation, and this exudation met with hairs and wounds and it forms a clumps. There is formation of lot of crust and scab. This is the characteristic of the disease. We discuss here the etiology. The name of bacteria is Dermatophilus congolensis. It is a gram positive, non-acid fast, and has a multiphasic life cycle. The life cycle is in a different stage. This life cycle occupies a distinct niches at different stages of life. So it is a multiphasic life cycle. Characteristic of organism is organism produce motile spores known as zoospores. Motile spores known as zoospores. The organisms are facultative anaerobic, belongs to actinomycetes group. We continue with the etiology. The Dermatophilus congolensis has two characteristic morphological forms. One, the motile zoospores, and the other is the filamentous hyphae. The filamentous hyphae are branching filaments. There are various fragments by septa, the longitudinal septa and transverse septa. Thus, in the hyphae, there is multidimensional septation, and they separate into the group of coccoid cells. This is the hyphae coccoid cells. Now another is the motile zoospores. These coccoid cells mature and become ovoid flagellated motile zoospores. This is the another characteristic. Remember this characteristic of the dermatophilosis. Friends, we discuss here epidemiology and various parts. The disease is prevalent in all tropical and temperate regions of the world, because these temperate and tropical regions are the world humid climate that is favorable for the Dermatophilus congolensis. The disease has great economic impact and causes major economic losses in many countries, Africa, Australia, America, India and Bangladesh. The dermatophilosis is a disease of skin. It causes damage to hide. So it causes a great loss to the leather industry of the cattle. The disease causes a wool loss, so it is a wool loss to the sheep. The disease causes dermatitis on the legs of the horses, so lameness and performance loss in the horses. Here we see predisposing factors. Predisposing factors are very important for the establishment of disease. Moist and cold weather, especially prolonged wetting by rainfall, causes many epidemic outbreaks of the disease. The concurrent infection with the contagious ectomancy also invite the disease. The high humidity and high temperature favors the multiplication of the ectoparasites. Ectoparasites cause biting on the skin. This biting injury favors the entry of Dermatophilus congolensis into the skin. This is a very important factor. The ectoparasites, abundant of biting arthropods such as ticks, Cercoptes, Demodex, mosquitoes, stinging and blood-sucking flies, all causes a skin injury which facilitates the entry of the organism. Friends, we discuss here transmission. Transmission is mostly by direct contact with either infected material or infected animal. The disease is transmitted mechanically by infected instruments, brushes, harnesses, bedding materials, etc. Various vectors act as a mechanical vector. The vector carry infection from one animal to another mechanical. Vector bite on the skin and causes skin injury. And through the skin injury, it facilitates the entry of dermatophilus organism and help in establishment of the infection. So, ectoparasites also causes disease transmission. Continue the discussion on transmission. Contaminated dipping fluid is an important source of transmission. During dipping, if one animal is infected, it sheds the infection into the dipping fluid and it transmits the infection to the other animals. During shearing, the shearing instrument also transmits infection from one animal to other animal. Also, the shearing instruments may cause abrasion or injury on the skin. So, it facilitates the entry of dermatophilus organism through abraded or injured skin. It is also observed that infections remain in a cushioned form in epidermis. But when they get factors like vectors, heavy rainfall, constant wetting, they start multiply and start producing the disease. So it requires a predisposing factor for establishment of the infection. Friends, here we discuss host affected by Dermatophilus congolensis. Diseases most commonly occur in cattle, sheep and horses. Commonly occur. All ages are affected, but the disease is more prevalent in young animals, and to those young animals which are chronic exposure to moisture, constant wetting of the skin, heavy rainfall, because this disease requires predisposing factor. Constant wetting of the skin, heavy rainfall, moisture. This is also observed in young animals, those which are immunosuppressed. When there is less immunity, the disease occurs. So, disease occurs in all ages, but more prevalent in young animals, which are chronically exposed to the wetting and immunosuppressed animals. Friends, we have seen that diseases commonly occur in cattle, sheep and horses. But disease also reported in wide variety of animals. Goats, donkeys, dogs, fox, cat, deer, many wild animals, pigs, monkeys and many animals. It is experimentally transmitted to camels, rabbits also. Friends, remember, the dermatophilosis is a zoonotic disease and man is readily infected when he comes in contact with the infected animals. So as a clinician and for the diagnosis and treatment, it is important for the veterinarian. Please be careful. Friends, here I have discussed the important information about dermatophilosis. Its synonym, introduction, etiology and epidemiology. Important points are discussed. Please share this information to veterinary friends and veterinary students. To uplift and progress of the channel, request you to subscribe the channel. Thank you very much for observing this video.